You're listening to PetLifeRadio.com.
Is your pet stressed out? Does your pet need annual vaccines? Which pet is best for a child? Would you know if your dog was in pain? Pet Life Radio presents The Pet Doctor, where you'll learn everything about keeping your pet healthy and happy. From pet care, pet meds and grooming, to pet food, pet insurance and dental care, this is the place to find out everything there is to know about pet wellness. Whether you have a dog, cat, reptile or rabbit, you'll find answers for your pets straight from the vets, because it's your pet. Health matters. Please welcome your Pet Doctor host, veterinary media consultant and veterinarian, Dr. Bernadine Cruz.
We treat them like our kids. Daycare, psychics, designer clothing, all sorts of gizmos, gadgets, and toys to keep them happy. But are we keeping them safe? What are they doing when we aren't with them? Are they getting into trouble in the house or just miss us? And can we keep them safe from predators, even when we're not by their sides? My next two guests have developed two amazing products that will help us communicate with our pets and keep them out of the jaws of danger. We'll be right back after this short break.
Please have a seat in the waiting room. The doctor will be with you shortly, right after these messages.
There's nothing more delicious and healthy than an old family recipe. And for over 50 years, our family's been creating them especially for your pets. Nutrisource Super Premium Pet Foods. Dog and cat food that's all natural, holistic, and organic. Nutrisource Pet Foods contain our patented Good for Life system for your pet's optimum health and well-being. So, order now. Safe quality food made by our family for your furry family members. Go to NutrisourcePetFoods.com.
From our family to yours, KLN Family Brands.
Tired of wasting money on giant boxes of litter that don't work and don't last? Switch to World's Best Cat Litter, the only litter with concentrated power. So even a small bag lasts one cat 30 days. Outstanding odor control, quick clumping, lightweight. It's even flushable. World's Best Cat Litter. Everything else is just litter. Find it near you at www.itsnotjustlitter.com. That's www.itsnotjustlitter.com.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com. Welcome back to The Pet Doctor on Pet Life Radio with Dr. Bernadine Cruz. The doctor is in and we'll see you now.
Watch, play, share. These three words epitomize the Pet Cube company, for whom my guest, Yulia Zimmerman, serves as business development manager. Yulia, thank you very much for being with us today.
Thank you, Bernadine. It's a pleasure.
Well, first off, I received a Pet Cube, and I just think it's a fabulous, fabulous thing. And, you know, looking forward, because I have to get it set up still, looking forward to kind of watching my cats when I'm not home, seeing what they're getting into. But tell the listeners, what is a Pet Cube?
So Pet Cube is a unique home camera for pet owners. Both iOS and Android compatible, this revolutionary gadget allows you to see if your puppy is chewing on a new shoe, but also has a built-in microphone and a speaker that gives you an ability to tell the pooch to put that shoe down. On top of everything, it has a fantastic, unique laser built-in, so you can exercise your pet by playing an exciting laser chasing game from your phone when you're not at home. So this Pet Cube is really about giving different kind of interactive tools to pet owners to monitor their pets, to make sure they're okay, to interact with them, and always know to have that peace of mind. They are okay.
And that's so important. I have so many of my clients who come in and say, you know, I work so many hours and I'm wondering, you know, is my pet eating or is it getting into trouble? I think it may have separation anxiety and, you know, I leave for 10 minutes and the pet's okay, but I have no idea when does it start, you know, showing signs of distress, or my neighbor keeps saying my dog is barking all the time and I don't think it's my dog. There's a lot of different indications where you can use this Pet Cube.
Absolutely, Bernadine. In fact, anxiety, you know, is the main reason why one of the founders came up with the first prototype of PetCube. He has a chihuahua, and Rocky is a really happy little chihuahua. However, when Alex was out of his house, he started getting phone calls from his neighbors accusing him that his dog is making noise. And he was like, no way, you know, my little Rocky is such a well-behaved dog. So he decided to build a little robot, you know, build a little camera to see what is Rocky up to. And sure enough, Rocky was there behind the door barking, because this is the spot where he last saw Alex before he left. However, Rocky absolutely loved laser. And what Alex came up with an idea is to not only be able to see Rocky, but also build in a mic so he can talk to him and attach a little laser pointer to make sure he can play with Rocky. And that was a solution. He also built a website, and some friends could join it and see what's going on and play with Rocky. And there it was. People just wanted this tool for themselves. This is fascinating, you know, PetCube doesn't only give you a chance to play and monitor your own pet. You can share access within PetCube network with friends and family, so your sister or your pet sitter or your mom can check on your dog or cat when you're hiking somewhere, there's no cell phone connection and you're so worried. Well, now someone else can check on them. And also, if you don't have your own pets, you can be playing with other people's pets.
I see some good things about that. We'll talk about it in just a minute. I can see some possible downsides of somebody checking in maybe when you don't know they're checking in. I guess we need to have a privacy, you know, little button or a privacy screen on this pet cube. But I first want to talk a little bit about these inventors. So Alexander Neskin, Andrew Maple, Jaroslav, how do you pronounce his last name?
Jaroslav Arzhnyuk.
And all of these, and I hear your accent also, so are all of you of the same ethnic background?
Yes, we all are coming from Ukraine.
And I loved reading your story. I went online and was reading up about PetCube, the inventors, and they're all less than 30 years of age and such fabulous entrepreneurs that you've come up with this idea and you've gotten it going. Give a little bit of background about the three inventors and yourself.
So Alex, Andrei, and Yaroslav have started this company together after this idea was born out of story with Rocky, Alexander Neskin, little chihuahua. And truly, you know, the guys have just very strong educational background. They always were resourceful and they saw an opportunity, you know, being pet lovers. And they saw that this can become a problem solving for pet owners and a business opportunity. And from there, they start building a team. And the team is really strong. You know, we have right now research and development in Kyiv. We produce pet cubes in Shenzhen, China. And now we're headquartered here in San Francisco between founders and me. And we're planning on growing our team in US this year as well. So, you know, guys decided to go to Kickstarter when they knew the idea is strong. They were committed and they wanted to test out the response. And the response was amazing. I'm not sure if you checked, but PetCube became the most funded pet product on a Kickstarter. I hope you had a chance to see the video the guys made and to learn about the project. You know, this was clear to the team that this is something that we need to pursue. This is something we're committed and passionate to give pet owners this camera to make sure they can get in touch and stay connected to their pets.
And Yulia, this really started pretty quickly. I mean, they came up with the idea, if I remember correctly. It's like only like 2 or 3 years from concept to going to China, to the electronics capital of the world, pulling it together, having this incubator that was there of all these people who could, you know, mentors and geniuses and people who knew what they were doing. So you really have gone from Ukraine to China to now San Francisco. Why have you decided, well, number one, answer the question, how long has it been from concept to delivery?
From concept to delivery, you know, and I think it was something around a year and a half, you know, which is, it's
pretty,
it's pretty hard for hardware. You know, hardware product is really something that has so many things you do not know until you start doing it. And I think, you know, what guys did, they went to China and participated in incubator. And that was really a tremendous learning experience, because from the beginning, their set mind was to learn from the best. And I think that was very ambitious, however, the only right way to go. So they went to incubator, you know, they went to the program, they went and met with mentors who really believed in their idea. So they got truly good advice and knowledge. From there, they could build a product. I also think they have a very good division in responsibilities, given that there's three founders. Yaroslav is CEO, Alex Neskin is STO, who is constantly goes to China and makes sure, you know, pet cubes are made nice and well. And that's why our batches are limited, because, you know, he really puts extra love and care for each one of them. And Andrei Klein, actually, he is an amazing creative director. All of our materials are just, you know, shine with stunning design. And we're really grateful for a strong design department that Andrei managed to build. And at the same time, he's the chief operations officer. So
what I love about the Pet Cube is that it just is very unobtrusive. It's not too large. You could definitely see it's going to fit in, you know, on a bookcase, on top of your shelf where you're feeding your cat. You can have it anywhere. It's not something that's like, oh my goodness, what is this huge thing? It really is very discreet, but very stylish.
Yeah, it has that, you know, hidden feature of a nice home monitoring system overall, right? Because not every thief would even understand this is a camera. So that sleek modern design also gives a nice chance to not be seen as a camera right away. So you can spy on a thief, you know.
We're not trying to spy on our pets or anyone else who may be home with the pet. But now that you brought that up, what are the safety features? Because here you say, okay, you know, it's a wonderful idea. I'm traveling someplace and I don't have cell phone access, but my sister can go ahead and get onto my system, check on the cats, make sure that they're okay, make sure my pet sitter is doing what he or she's supposed to be doing. How do I know that in the middle of the night somebody's not turning it on and watching me?
Bernadine, that's a great question, you know, and I wish more people would ask it right away. And of course, we thought about from the start. In fact, you know, really care about security, and PetCube is encrypted on both software and hardware levels, so it's really hard to break into the system. So the share feature of PetCube, you know, the thing is, you are the one, you, the owner of PetCube, is the one who will define when, on which day of the week, for how many hours, anyone else would be accessing your PetCube. So actually, great. You are in control, knowing exactly when, who, and for how long will be accessing your PetCube camera. And if you just want to give your sister an access for an hour a week, that's fine. If you are, like I said, away on a long vacation, and you want to make sure that your elderly pet gets, you know, an attention and can be checked on 24/7, well, you have that opportunity as well.
That is great. I love that feature. Very good. Because I'm just going up the learning curve with my pet cube. So thank you for that. What I find interesting, the three inventors and yourself, being from Ukraine, you could go to anywhere literally in the world. You could have really started this in Europe. You could have started it in Australia, China, you know, the billions of people there in China. Why did you decide to come to the United States, to North America, and really get your headquarters here and launch it in the United States?
Well, Bernadine, that actually the answer is pretty easy, because living in San Francisco for 7 years, there were times when I literally thought there's more dogs than kids in this city. So we are talking about 60% of people in U.S. owning pets. You know, we're talking about $55 billion pet market in U.S. So we came where the market was. You know, where the market was, where society is ready for pet technology. In fact, it's so ready. We really think 2015 will be a big year for pet technology, for pet wearables. So I think guys had a really good, did their homework, basically, you know, where to go, where to expand. And this was the right choice. We're very happy with our users in US. This is exactly the spot we want to be at.
What you were saying, the number of dogs there are in San Francisco, after looking at some of your information on Pet Cubes, I mean, there's more pets in the United States than children. It's like, really? So I did, of course, my little Google search. At least in 2014, they're saying there's 74.5 million children in the United States from age 0 to 17. And then there's 95.6 million cats and 83.3 million dogs. So, Yulia, you are correct. Pet cubes.
Wow, yes.
There's a heck of a lot more dogs and cats than there are children. So, yes, I can see why you came here. And I think one of the bad things about Pet Cube is that now I'm going to be spending much more time on YouTube and looking at these videos, because Pet Cube is also a content generator. So it's a community. I can talk to other Pet Cube owners. I can watch their videos. Like, I don't have enough, you know, cute cat and dog videos to watch. So you really are going to be bringing people together.
Absolutely. You know, in fact, we're really committed to fostering pet lovers community, and the mobile Pet Cube app is not only your way to connect to your Pet Cube home camera, it is also a social hub for pet lovers to connect, to discover, to invent. Eventually, you know, there's a lot of things that will be happening. It will be really becoming a one-stop app for pet owners, where there will be services, there will be shopping, there will be educational resources and other useful stuff for pet owners.
I'm so passionate about education. That's a great way to get them information. So again, this is for Android and also for iOS. So you can either have your iPhone or you can have your Android phone. Both will work with it. Can you also use it with an iPad?
No, you only can use it with a smartphone at the moment.
Okay. I think this is marvelous. And people are listening to this going, all right, how much? This thing is going to have to be extremely expensive because it does all these great things. Yulia, a Pet Cube. How much is a Pet Cube?
Pet Cube is $1.99, and you can buy it from our website, petcube.com, or from Amazon. And remember, this is a luxurious item, but it's a very functional, elegant, and fun solution for people and their pets that need a little long-distance love and attention. And this is also a unique gadget. This is the only camera with laser built-in. You have to understand technology, research development that's gone behind this product. We're very committed to improving our product every step of the way. So what you're going to see in the future is just better PetCube and better PetCube community.
Well, I think $199 is not all that expensive for everything that you have available with it. Keeping yourself from getting into a lawsuit with your neighbor because you have a barking dog or a dog or cat that undergoes separation anxiety. There are so many good reasons for this, and the price really, I think, is very reasonable.
And it's free shipping in US, even though we do deliver globally.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much. If people want to learn more about Pet Cube, where should they go again?
They should go to petcube.com. I also wanted to mention, Bernadine, that we also develop Pet Cube for Shelters program. Mm. So I am personally working with local shelters. I want to help them to raise adoptions rate, collect more donations, and for people to discover more shelters. So if anyone is interested in joining our Pet Cube for Shelters program, they can simply contact me at yulia.z@petcube.com, and I'll happily help them as well.
And Yulia, so it's yulia.zi?
Z-I, yes.
Okay. Fabulous. Well, Yulia, thank you so much for being with us, and thank you for my Pet Cube. I know my kitties are going to appreciate mom saying, stop it, don't do that, and play with them too.
Thank you, Bernadine. You could also tell them one more time how much you love them. I'm sure they'll appreciate that too.
Definitely, definitely. This is Dr. Bernadine Cruz. Please stay tuned. We're going to have more information on how to make you one of the best pet owners possible. Stay tuned for part two of this show.
Please have a seat in the waiting room. The doctor will be with you shortly, right after these messages.
Amazing Pet Expos is coming to a city near you. Admission is always free, and your pet is welcome. Shopping, adoptions, free nail trims, discounted shots and microchipping, agility, a pet costume contest, and much more. Plus, meet the guys from Animal Planet's hit TV series Tank and Pit Boss. Online at AmazingPetExpos.com.
Bring your pets to the Pet Expo.
It's DesignerPetSweaters.com. Hand-knitted designer sweaters for your precious pup or cool cat. Beautiful couture patterns for your pets, including custom-knitted formal wear, casual wear, yachting, and even sports-themed. Many designer pet sweaters include feathered tammy hats, top hats, and a lot of sparkle. Each sweater includes leg loops, front paw sleeves, and leash opening. Visit DesignerPetSweaters.com to order your four-legged fashions today. Large or small, we fit them all. DesignerPetSweaters.com.
Hi, this is T.O.D. Anderson, and I'm the host of Get Positive Results on Pet Life Radio. We're going to talk about a variety of topics on canine behavior and training, all based on modern methods that are fun for you and your dog. We might be talking about other critters, too. So join us on Get Positive Results. We'll talk about common issues between you and your dog, answer your questions, discuss different activities you can do with your dog, and keep you posted on current canine news and products. All this on Get Positive Results on Pet Life Radio.
Let's talk pets. On Pet Life Radio.
Pet Life Radio.
PetLifeRadio.com.
Welcome back to The Pet Doctor on Pet Life Radio with Dr. Bernadine Cruz. The doctor is in and we'll see you now.
Thanks very much for staying tuned. So we talked about ways that you can monitor and interact with your pet, trying to keep them safe when you're not there. But sometimes, even when you are with them, you're walking with them, they can be attacked by a dog, a coyote, and it's just devastating. My guest right now is Johnny Dumas. Johnny is an entrepreneur who's come up with a great idea, basically a modern-day shark suit for dogs. Johnny, thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
Well, I have never seen anything like this in the past. Tell me, how did you come up with the idea?
Well, you know, living in Southern California, we are saturated with coyotes stalking our pets and jumping over fences to attack our pets. And I currently have a smaller dog. She's like a little chill wiener. Her name is Maggie. So cute. And, you know, we were letting her out one night, and I was asked the question, what are you going to do when a coyote attacks your dog? And in my mind, the first thing I came up with was a response, I'm going to make her a jacket that contains spikes. And it just took off from there.
And it is so common, being here in Southern California myself, and I know coyotes are not just a urban problem, they're in the suburbs, they're really throughout the United States. More areas have more coyote population than others. But oftentimes people who move into Southern California and say they moved here from Iowa, maybe don't have a lot of coyotes there, say, oh, well, we have a 5-foot fence in the backyard, or we have a 6-foot fence, or, you know, I'm always with my dog. And that doesn't always help. If you can kind of, Johnny, give us a little bit of background about the coyote mentality and what they're good at, namely jumping fences and taking our pets.
You know, coyotes, they're an extravagant animal. Back when, a while ago, almost close to 100 years ago, there was a study done in Maine, and they took about 22 coyotes, and they tested them to see, you know, where their ancestry came from. And the majority of those coyotes actually had an ancestry of the gray wolf. You know, this enabled them to become a hybrid of a type of coyote. So usually when you see a coyote and it looks a little bit larger than your average coyote, 9 times out of 10, they have an ancestor that's a wolf. This enables them to jump 15 feet over fences, also to dig. The scary part about them digging is they don't necessarily have to inhabit something that's meant for them. They can take a burrow from anything, a groundhog, a gopher, and they can dig it out about 6 feet. And it's been numerous occasions where you will hear about coyotes digging into these burrowing right next to schools, parks, and outside of your home. You would never know. So when we came up with the spike bite, you know, within the household, the main factors we looked for were comfort and safety. The fact of the matter is, spike bite can be something that can save your pet's life, but only for that initial moment. We wouldn't advise someone to just put spike bite on their pet and allow spike bite to be the owner. Spike bite is to prevent and deter the initial attack, alleviating the stress and pain from, you know, you losing your pet, and giving your pet an opportunity to run for its life, whether that's into the house, under a car, or into your arms.
Johnny, please describe what a spike bite is. Thank you very much for sending me one. Brought it to the hospital, opened up the package. Everyone's looking at this thing, which was just really cute colors. It was extremely light, very well made. I like the fact that it was easy to put on, so it wasn't something where it's like, oh, this is a pain in the derriere. We're just going to go out this one time. I'm not going to put your spike bite little shirt on. We're just going to go outside and oops, that's the time, like driving without your seatbelt on. But it was cute. It was light. Explain to the listeners, and I know they can go to your website. Explain what it is.
So the spike bite vest, it's a vest that's made out of neoprene. We usually, within the neoprene, we'll use stab-proof Kevlar, and this is what correctional officers and police officers use as a stab-resistant material that will stop most objects such as ballistic materials like bullets and knives. This is going to be throughout the entire vest. So your dog is going to be stab-proof. Now, after the initial attack, if the attacking animal continues to try to maul your pet to death, like chew through the vest, they will contact spikes, which are embedded within a dense layer of padding. And we strategically place this padding around the most vital areas of your pet. And the vital areas would be the neck, the back, stomach, and ribs. These areas that are usually not so bad of a laceration in big dogs can really be a fatal blow to your smaller dog, for they are not necessarily equipped with the body to take a puncture wound to the chest, to the side, and so forth. And it's really sad, too, because, you know, I spoke with one of my customers just recently, and I decided to record her story. And the worst part about the story was the rebuttal that I constantly get when people say, oh, this will never happen to my dog.
True.
My dog, we don't have coyotes. We don't have hawks. I barely walk my dog. I just let my dog out to pee. You know, this woman, she told me about the story with her pet. She would take her pet over to her mother's house every day, and they would play with the other dogs in the household. She said they would sleep together, they would eat together. And an unforeseen occasion occurred where she was hanging in outside of the vicinity of the home, and the larger dog, which was her mother's dog, took a fast snap at her Pomeranian, and she lost her Pomeranian. This woman was in tears while she was telling me the story. And it's tragic. It's very tragic, and we should do what we can do to be responsible to ensure the safety of our pets.
So, Johnny, you're exactly right. You know, spike bite could be used in a situation not just when you're out walking your pet, but in situations where maybe it's going to a dog park or it's going to doggy daycare or someplace where it's just not really sure. And sometimes it's not even always the other dog's fault fully, because sometimes little dogs can get scared and they can get a little on the yappy, aggressive side because they're nervous and trying to protect themselves. And a bigger dog can say, you know, kid, you're bugging me, and just go in with that bite. It can happen so fast, as you were saying.
It's very sad, you know, and it can happen really fast. I really believe that spike bite is something that has numerous applications, and we can tailor it to fit any type of mammal that's a pet. And if you have a larger dog, we can protect the jugular of that pet, because a larger animal would not suffer too bad from body lacerations, but the throat would be something that would be a vital blow to them. And if there was a situation that occurred where you had two pets in the household and one pet would attack the other pet, you don't have to think that our product is inhumane because we only use quarter-inch spikes. So it's going to be relatively little damage done to the attacking dog. It's just something that's going to stun them briefly.
Probably startle them so it says, ouch, this hurts, this one doesn't taste good, we'll go for another one. What I like about Spike Bite is that, yes, you can use it for the small dogs, you can use it for larger ones. Here in Southern California and other places too, where you're, boy, I want to get some exercise with my dog, I want to take it, you know, maybe up into the hills, into a less populated area, maybe even let it off leash so it can get out there and run around, and then all of a sudden it's attacked by some wild animal that's just laying there, and it's like, wait a minute, you came into my territory, I'm going to attack you. So it can be used for big and small, but what I like about it too is that it seems to be reflective. So at night, especially these little pets, as you're walking, many times you'll see the person, but you, oh, I didn't see that dog at the end of the leash. But you can also use it for flotation. Tell us about that.
Yes, well, we have numerous features to our Spike Bite vest. It not just pokes, but as you said, it reflects light in areas of little light, and it floats as well. It's going to be very, very lightweight. Our vest only goes up to about 7 ounces.
And I was amazing how light it was, yes.
Yes, you know, and that's due to the materials we use. We try to use a lot of light materials. I would say the heaviest thing that we use are probably the spikes. We try to use stainless steel spikes to make sure there's no corroding and, you know, that it stays intact and doesn't really move around too much. Our products, it's American-made. We're able to add buckles for extra security and extra pockets in case you need to, you know, put a little GPS inside of the vest or, you know, store your own cell phone. You know, we try to do everything we can in our power, and we're also always taking suggestions online because it being a new product and working with the customers directly, we're able to take feedback and grow relationships. When we first started, we didn't have all the buckles. We didn't have the leash compatibility. It did not float. It was a lot of things we didn't have. And the reason those things came into being was because, you know, we listened to our customer. We understood that the person buying Spike Bite was a person that was being active and usually in an area with, you know, other animals in an occasion where, you know, unforeseen occurrences naturally occur. So we take all those things into account, definitely.
I like it that Spike Bite is a very interactive company and that it's very customizable. Liking the fact that it's reflective. Many of my clients at my particular animal hospital were surrounded by a senior community, and a lot of these people are panicked to take their pets out as soon as it get dusk. They are not taking these pets out, and they need to get some exercise. You know, sometimes you need to go to the bathroom. And I've had clients just, okay, you got to go potty, it's raining or it's cold, I'll just let you out in the backyard. And in just that nanosecond, they're snatched and taken away. Or even, I've had clients, many of these are seniors again, a pet is on that leash using their retractable leashes, which I personally detest retractable leashes because you don't have as much control over them as you should. Pets at the end of the leash, it has its, you know, little collar on, and all of a sudden, coyote comes out of nowhere, snatches it, knocks the person down, sometimes injuring them. So this is a way, keep it close, keep it, you know, a way that you'll be having a greater chance. You can't say 100% it's going to keep it from dying, but it increases the likelihood that you'll be able to get medical attention and treat something instead of, oh my goodness, it was just snatched and taken away.
This is so true. And, you know, I look at all of the aspects of the product. It saves your pet, and it will possibly save your marriage. Because think about it. If you take your wife's pet out to get attacked by coyotes, 9 times out of 10, if you still have a wife at the end, you'll be sleeping on the couch.
That's a very good way to think about it. So you came up with the Spike Bite. Was one of your pets attacked, or you just thought, I've heard of too many dogs?
Oh, yes, doctor. It was my pet, Maggie. She was so cute, and she's so vulnerable, and she's just the sweetest little thing, and I just needed to be able to protect her from being attacked. The initial prototype was it was funny. It was a rollerblade brace for your hand. That's how tiny she was. I made her vest out of a little, but it was a children's. It's a child size for a little guard for your hand for when you rollerblade. Uh-huh. And I took the initial, we took some push pins. I put them on the inside, had them protruding out. She looked like a certified porcupine. But then I said, you know, we just weaponized a hand brace. Let's make it safe. So then I said, okay, let's use some dense cushioning. And, you know, when I try to briefly describe Spike Bite to people, they go, oh, it's a porcupine vest. But I try to let them know, you know, we have armor, we have Kevlar, so it's a porcupine vest, but it's more of a porcupine that has a grandfather that's an armadillo.
It's a stylish porcupine, extremely stylish.
Definitely.
And a light one. So you had this weaponized skate glove
brace.
On your pet, brace on your pet. How do you test it? You know, the first person who came up with a shark suit and said, okay, I need a person to put this on and get in with a shark is like, really? That's not going to be me. How have you tested this?
Well, the first test that we ran, it was a home test. I accidentally sat on it and I accidentally stepped on it. Then I knew it worked. I totally knew it worked. I said, oh, I'm onto something, because this just tore me up. And I'm a tough guy. You know, I'm the type. I don't go to the hospital. I have to, like, literally be bleeding out of my ear to go see a doctor. And for me to hurt myself. Yes, so for me to hurt myself, I said, okay, you know, this is something that will protect our pets. But then I needed to really have a real test. But I know that, like, it would be a little inhumane to just have something unsuspecting bite into spikes. So what I did was I took the second half of that test, removed the spikes, and just had the vest as a comfort vest with the neoprene and with the stab-proof Kevlar. And then we put that over, you know, a fake dog. And then we had a canine attack that vest, and it was puncture-proof.
Fabulous.
So definitely. So regardless of the spikes or whatnot, your dog is going to be stab-proof. And then if the animal that's attacking wants to go further into attacking the stab-proof vest, they will incur spikes.
And one thing you said right now was that it's a comfort vest, and they do have these various neoprene jackets that you can put on cats and dogs. And I tell people it's just like giving them this big hug. Like when you're scared, you're a big guy, Johnny, you come up and you give me this big hug. It's like, okay, it's not so bad. So you're doing the same thing with the spike bite.
Yes, we are. And I didn't even think to do it with the competitors that have, like, the thunder coats and so forth. It was actually me having a son, you know, my little baby. When I tucked him in and I wrapped him up like a little burrito, he was secure and everything was okay. And this was him being only a few hours old, not really knowing his surroundings. And that made the difference. His comfort, his tightness, his being wrapped up real tight, it was the big difference between him crying all night and comfortably sleeping. So I made sure I incorporated that into the vest, definitely.
Baby burritos are marvelous. We have pets waking up from anesthesia. We'll always put them into these little baby burritos, and the snugger they are, yes,
happier.
They just wake up, yes, so much more relaxed. Johnny, this is a fabulous, fabulous idea. I love it. We're going to be carrying it at our hospital. If people want to buy one, where can they learn about it? Where can they buy them? Because people are going to be listening to this outside of Southern California.
Well, you know, like I said earlier, we really pride ourselves on being interactive with our customers. So we are not necessarily looking for stores to retail our product. We want our customers to come to us, speak to us, and make suggestions to us so we can, you know, satisfy their needs and make sure that, you know, their pets are, that they have the right sizes and they have the right weight on them. So with that being said, you can find us on spikebite.com. That's SPIKEBITE.com. Also, 855-86-SPIKE. It's a toll-free number, and someone is always next to the phone waiting for a call.
And we'll have this on our website. So, Johnny Dumas of Spike Bite, thank you very much for coming up with the modern-day shark suit for dogs. I know it's going to really help protect so many people and make people want to get out with their dogs, even if it's maybe a little bit dark, and know that they can get some exercise and have that wonderful bonding between them and their dogs. So, thank you very much for being on the show today.
Thank you so much, Dr. Cruz. I really appreciate what you are doing. You know, enlightening. You enlighten me. You enlighten all of your listeners. And without you, there's no me, because you're helping project my voice. So I appreciate it.
You're welcome very much, Johnny. I also want to mention I had a very nice feedback from one of our listeners the other day, Buddy from Erie, Pennsylvania. We had a episode talking about service dogs and fake service dogs. He has a service dog and he thinks we really need to improve the education to people and business owners when sometimes you have a dog that's coming in that may not be a service dog and they're taking advantage of it. You can ask. There's nothing wrong with that. So if there's something, listeners, that you want to learn more about, what are your interests, please go ahead, drop me a line at the Pet Doctor at PetLifeRadio.com. So thank you very much for listening. Please tune in again next week. We'll have more information on how to make you the best possible pet owner. Take care.
Pets can be a wonderful addition to your life because they're a member of the family. Keeping them healthy and happy is important. Pet Life Radio presents The Pet Doctor with veterinary media consultant and veterinarian Dr. Bernadine Cruz. Whether you have a dog, cat, reptile, or rabbit, you'll find answers for your pets straight from the vets. The Pet Doctor, on demand every week, only on PetLifeRadio.com.